GHSA football championships are presented by the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, reminding you to buckle up, Georgia. Division II Flag Football State Championship features the Lithia Springs Lions undefeated in 2022 against the Central Carroll Lions out of Carrollton, Georgia. Good afternoon, I'm Wiley Ballard, joined by the state's foremost expert in flag football, David Reynolds. And Dave, we've already got one championship in the books. Southeast Bullock wins Division I Class A through 4A. And in case you missed it or you're still familiarizing yourself with flag football, can we walk through some of the rules and the distinctions between flag football and tackle football?
Yeah, the football field this morning will look a little different. 80 yards long, 40 yards wide. First downs will be achieved by gaining the zone line to gain, which are fixed 20 yards apart. We'll play two 20-minute halves with the first 19 minutes being a running clock. Once we get under 1 minute of the half, the clock will run similar to high school tackle football, so the clock will stop on incomplete passes, scores, and so forth. Every player is eligible to catch a forward pass, so see the center get involved in the passing game today. Last one, flag football, non-contact sport. So think of basketball where players will not initiate contact. They'll use string blocking and so forth today on the flag football field.
Now, if you like defense, Lithia Springs is the team for you. They've given up one touchdown in their 18 games this season. They're undefeated. They've got a lot of contributors all over the field, but Nevaeh Shredrick has been a difference maker for Lithia Springs.
Absolutely playmaker. She's back, baby. If you remember her from last year, leads the ground game for the Lions with 19 touchdowns on the season. Straight-A student, and only gotten better as her running for her rushing game. On defense, she pulls flags with attitude. 50 tackles on the season. The Lions came up short last year. Today for the Lions to win, we'll see her be a big part of this.
Now, defensively for Lithia Springs, they'll have a challenge in facing the running quarterback, Camry McEwen, for Central High School out of Carrollton. She's lightning quick.
And as she goes, the team will go. The absolute captain of the team can really shift you when it comes to quarterbacks. She'll float around the field. Not the tallest player on the field, but with her speed, her threat to run and pass, makes a big difference in the game. Had a huge interception in the semifinals last week in limited time on defense. Look for the quarterback here to have a big day if the Tigers are going to have success.
Well, it's a Lions versus Lions state championship. Who will come out as the leader of the pride? We'll find out shortly. Before we get started, let's send it back down to John Nelson on the sidelines at Center Park.
So let me guess, Wiley. So the Lions are going to win this one. I was waiting for one of you two to sit there and drop that line.
I feel confident one of the Lions will come out on top.
Right there with you, brother. Get it back to you in just a second. If you believe in numerology and symmetry, they mentioned, Dave and Wiley, about how the Lithia Springs defense has just been absolutely stout. Let me talk about their offense for a second. First two rounds, they scored a total of 27 points, outscoring their opposition. Rounds 3 and 4, they scored 27 points total to outscore their opposition. Now, when you look at Lithia Springs once again, 21-0, 6-0, 20-0, and 7-0. That's what they've done in the playoffs to get to this particular point in time. Let's go to the flip side and talk about Central Carroll. Central Carroll has won games different ways here in their run to the last game of the year. For Central Carroll, they've scored in the 20s. They've won two games 7-6. So you mentioned how things can shift one way or the other. There's always that back and forth. They have proven, Central Carroll, that they can win games by putting a lot of points on the board, but they can also win the nail biters. Lithia Springs has had a couple of nail biters, winning in the semis 7-0, winning in the second round 6-0. So we'll see. They've handled it both ways. But Wiley and Dave, my question for you as we send it back upstairs, these two teams only played a couple days ago. I wonder how they'll respond to playing for the championship on this turf surface like they did up at the Atlanta Falcons facility. What do you think?
Well, John, I think that's a good question. And, you know, in the sport of flag football, Dave, we frequently see teams play 3-4 games in a single day. And I think the emotional ride that Central's been on specifically, I mean, they've won all four of their playoff games in the final possession.
Yeah, both these teams are built for playing multiple games and multiple days in the same week, so that won't be an issue. Maybe the nerves a little bit on the big stage here, right? This is big stage, TV's here, so we'll see how the nerves need to calm down a little bit early on for both these teams.
Lithia Springs, of course, fell in the state final last year. Central Carroll, who's won 7 straight games, they were the runners-up in Area 6. And this is their second year of flag football, led by first-year head coach Bronson Evester. It's about a 50-mile drive from Carrollton over here to downtown Atlanta. And as the Lithia Springs Lions take the field, they've got revenge on their mind here, Dave. Not necessarily geared towards Central, but they lost in this state final on this field, 6-0 in triple overtime. They've yet to lose a game since then in the state final last year. They've given up only one touchdown since that triple overtime game-winning touchdown from Dodge County.
Yeah, the Lions definitely remember last season. A successful season last year, right? Making it to the state championship is something worth note. But again, here today, leave no doubt. As what Coach Pleasant says, just leave no doubt, make sure they understand that the Lions are for real trying to complete that undefeated season.
There is head coach Kendra Pleasant huddling her team. Central Lions fans in the stands. And Coach Pleasant, you know, began her coaching career as a basketball coach. And it was in the May of 2021 when her AD, Philip Howard, asked her, hey, would you be willing to coach flag football? She said, of course, you know, I'd love to coach another girls' sport. And they really, when they put the program together, she felt like a lot of her girls were more comfortable playing defense. I mean, they said they always wanted to play tackle football. Offense has been more of a growth area. And we'll see what they do as Central wins the toss and has deferred. So Lithia Springs, with the first play from scrimmage, it's a give around the right side. Isaiah Phillips with the carry. And picks up a couple of yards. It is first and 6 from the 14 to begin every game. There are no kickoffs. And after that 3-yard rush, it is 2nd and 3. As you mentioned, Dave, get a look at Coach Bronson Evester, head coach for Central, but you know, the zones to gain, it is not your typical chain gang like you see in tackle football. It's all about gaining the zones. They're 3 yards away from getting another set of downs. Around the right side, and Shedrick has her flag pulled right around the line of scrimmage. Third down.
Two run plays here to start for the Lions today on offense. Trying to stretch the field east and west. Nice job there by the Central Lions on defense to stop that play where it's at.
Yeah, nice job by Chancey Powers getting upfield quickly. Got a tackle for loss, 3rd and 4. Minnex completes the pass, got the first down, and the flag comes off. Caught by Jaden Graham, the center. That's part of being all eligible. The center can be a big part of the passing offense. That's a 13-yard gain.
Yeah, to your point, nice job right there using the center. Jaden Graham is your outlet there. A little delayed rush there up front for the Central Lions. Janae Adams kind of hesitated a little bit, allowed for a little more time for the quarterback to sit there and go through her progression.
So after the gain, it's 1st and 12. Got to get to midfield for a new set of downs. A backward pass now lobbed down the middle to midfield, and it's complete to Hannah McIver. She was the area player of the year. Here's a look at the starting lineup for Lithia Springs offense. 7-on-7 flag football. You've got Nevaeh Shedrick, we touched on in the open. And Hannah McIver, as we mentioned, the area player of the year. Isaiah Phillips. And of course, the quarterback was Shia Minnix, who drops back to pass. On first down, she'll scramble up the middle. And the flag ripped away. That was Micaiah Long with the stop.
Yeah, I like the start here for Lithia Springs. A little more pass-oriented offense. Nice job right there. Heads up quarterback. Eyes are downfield. Nothing's there. Tuck the football. Get up the field. Get something every single play. Puts you on time to get that line to game.
Loaded up on the right side. Minnex in and out of the hands, dropped by Isaiah Phillips. Central's defense, a look at their starting lineup for the Central Lions. Kaya Long, one of their senior leaders at linebacker. We've already called Chancey Powers' name once. And Janae Adams, the rusher up front, a critical position in flag football.
No rush here, though. Shedrick loops around the right side. She's got that track star speed. You know, Nevaeh Shedrick, she's just got that infectious personality, Dave. She's a straight-A student, great singer, won the talent show last year at Lithia Springs High School. We asked Coach Pleasance, you know, did she perform? You know, how did she do in the talent show this year? And she said, I think Nevaeh said she wanted to give somebody else a chance.
And there's no doubt why that makes her the team captain, on the field, off the field. Incredible person, incredible human being to be around.
So it says a fourth and short. Big play trying to extend the drive. This is my Angel Ross weaving back in. And where will they spot her? Looks like, yes, she got the first down. Needed two, got three.
Big conversion on this first drive. Just extends that ball across that line to gain. Only problem here now is sets up a first and 19 with the goal line being the line to gain.
So by Angel Ross, the sophomore, over 120 yards rushing this season. This is the ninth play of the drive. Pass completed in the backfield to Briel Holland. Couple of yards, maybe.
First year, Brita Holland here, being that second quarterback, get the ball on the edge again, trying to stretch out the defense east and west.
So Holland heads to the sideline. Ball spotted at the 17. And that pass too tall. Looking for Anaya Moore. And Rashaya Minix, Dave, a year ago, you wouldn't see her go to the air this much.
A lot different looking, although you have some similar players from last year. This first drive, a lot different looking offense, a little more through the air. That just shows the progression for the second year senior starter, excuse me, junior here for the offense.
Spent some time in the weight room building up her arm strength over the summer. Floats one over the middle, inside the five, and a good pull by Micaiah Long to keep McIver out of the end zone. But that sets up a fourth and short in a goal-to-go situation. 15-yard gain.
This crossing route here just shows you what big-time target the area player of the year is. Sure hands right there. Sure, brings up a fourth and goal here from the two-yard line. No field goals, so we're going for it.
In the express red zone, the defining play of the drive. To Shedrick around the left side, reaches, and she is yanked down. A flag's going to come out. So we call it a non-contact sport.
Very physical play right there that draws the flag. Nice hard run, gets ball outwards. Just a tackle right there. Not supposed to see from Peyton Blair there on defense.
Well, I suppose from a cost-benefit standpoint, that was a smart play if you felt like Shedrick was going to get in no matter what. I'm not sure it's in the spirit of the sport, but Peyton Blair doing whatever she had to keep Shedrick out of the end zone and gives the defense another chance to come up with a big stop. Less than a yard to go. Shedrick this time, no question about it. Nevaeh Shedrick with her 20th rushing touchdown of the season, and Lithia Springs marches all the way down the field for a touchdown on their opening drive.
Exactly what you want to look at if you're from Lithia Springs today. Nice hard run here to cap off about a 7-minute drive. It's a nice job there, all the way to slow and steady progressing down the football for the opening drive.
Minix going to the air on the extra point, and she completes it at the front corner of the end zone to Isaiah Phillips. And Coach Kendra Pleasant's team is up 7-0. And for a team that's given up just one touchdown this year, that 7-0 lead feels pretty big. One more look at this extra point.
Yeah, and then tack it on, right? Tackle on the extra point there. Just to cap off that with a bow, opening drive. Really good job there. For a team that's kind of struggled in the semis and the finals for Lithia Springs offensively, nice job there getting points on the board early on the first half.
It's 12 plays, 55 yards, 7 minutes, and 11 seconds off the clock. And now Central gets a chance to go to work offensively against the top scoring defense in the state. Cameron McEwen rolling right, and her flag pulled from the backside. Great hands from Imani Roberts, their junior rusher up front.
One-on-one matchup right there, quarterback versus the rusher. And the rusher's going to win. Imani Roberts picks up her 23rd sack on the season. That shows you how much confidence the coach has in Imani Roberts to only have one rusher. And again, to lock down that opening play there for the Central Lions.
You look at Coach Ivester with that chart. That was a chart he first introduced on Monday in the semifinals. Hadn't used it before. And once the game started, he realized I didn't study my chart well enough. He spent too much time looking at the numbers and trying to see what play he was trying to call. Cameron McEwen on a 5-yard rush. Here's a look at the offensive starters for Central High of Carrollton. In addition to McEwen, keep an eye on Chansey Powers. She's kind of their number two option offensively. But look, I mean, this whole thing starts and stops with Camry McEwen. Got hurt in the second round last year, had an ankle injury. That's one of the reasons why their run was a little shorter a year ago. Got knocked out in that second round game. McEwen, dilly-dallying, and thumbs it ahead, but too far ahead for Allie Edwards. Well, we've seen it. Three and out here for Central, and on this suffocating Lithia Springs defense.
Yeah, kind of frustrating there. Trying to extend the play, but again, hats off to Lithia Springs defense there. Just absolutely no options on the ground or in the air. Punt the ball away.
Will be Alyssa Robeson to punt. Get a look at Anaya Moore back deep. What a great punt. That is going to land just inside the field of play. By Angel Ross with the punt return. When we come back, Lithia Springs will look to add to their 7-0 lead. So far, so good for the Lions of the green and gold.
Sweetheart, please don't forget to wear your seatbelt.
I got it, Mom.
It's a really nice day, living in the right space. Breathing your face, got me feeling some kind of way.
Blink of an eye, so many tomorrows can disappear. Buckle up for your future. Every trip, every time. A message from the Governor's Office of Highway Safety.
Cigna is a proud partner of Georgia Public Broadcasting and Football Fridays. Cigna's mission is to improve the health, well-being, and peace of mind of those we serve. Visit Cigna.com to learn how you can support your physical and emotional well-being. Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
A little past halfway in this first half, Lithia Springs, Central Carroll, Lions on Lions. This is Area 6 against Area 6. These two teams met earlier this season back on November 9th. It was a 19-0 lead, or win, I should say, for Lithia Springs over Central. Three touchdowns for Lithia Springs. Only one offensive, though. There was a pick six and a punt return mixed in. And, you know, you don't want to get carried away in the first half, Dave, but with the way Lithia Springs has played defense this year, allowing just one touchdown all season, you don't want to say this is a must stop, but you can't afford to fall behind two scores in any flag game, but especially against this defense. And a great play from behind the line. Chansey Powers spins through and brings down Anaya Moore.
I mean, just flies in the camera angle. Whoa! And grabs that flag right there. Really nice job getting downhill and stopping that play right in its tracks.
So second down and 8 after a loss of 1. Sun peeking back out here at Center Park Stadium. A beautiful day to kick off championship weekend. And a tall target, Hannah McIver. Coach Pleasant says she doesn't have hands, she has gloves. They catch everything.
And you can see where we put this ball, just right up to where, again, only one person can catch this pass. Give me that right there. Nice job there. Cut the distance down. Now we have a third down and much more manageable here for the offense.
4 yards away from gaining the zone. Pump fake, and the ball did get away, incomplete. Minix nearly sacked. It brings up 4th and 4.
Nice job by the senior rusher up there with 2 shield blockers. Still has time to get the ball, get to the passer. Maybe quarterback wanted to get rid of that ball and couldn't on time.
Janae Adams. Now, in this 4th down situation, you have to announce, declare, whether you're going to go for it or you are going to punt. So Lithia Springs will go for it. Minix so far today, 5 for 8 for 50 yards, make it 5 for 9, and a big stop by Central as they make quick work of Lithia Springs there offensively. Lithia Springs gained just 3 yards.
3rd and 4th down, a little hesitation here by the quarterback. Is she open, is she not? Kind of panics a little bit there and just throws the ball away. So nice job there. Central Lions applying the pressure up front to get off the field very quickly.
So 7-0, second possession now for Central High School. Three receivers to the left from McEwen. Completes the pass down the left seam. Good solid hands. Lucy Wilkinson makes the grab. You know, that matchup in my mind, Dave, between Cambry McEwen, the Central's quarterback, and the rusher, Imani Roberts, is going to be very intriguing.
Yeah, right here, not backing down, number 21. The shiftiness of the quarterback. No concern for the rusher right there to apply the pressure, but get the ball out, get the ball downfield. Nice shot by the possession wide receiver. Pick up a little bit of gain right there.
Interesting formation here. A couple of receivers way back behind the line of scrimmage. Loosely stacked, if you will. The pass complete towards midfield. Catch was made by Allie Edwards that time. She had a touchdown pass in their semifinal win against East Coweta.
Put a couple people out really wide right there, stretched the defense. You can still see the offense there looking for that next pitch, almost trying to set up that hook and ladder. But nice job right there by Lion, the Lithia Springs Lions for stopping that player right there.
3rd and 1. Coach Ivester said that they are a grinded out team. Central, they want to shorten the game. Fewer possessions, the better. Chest pass, incomplete. And that brings up a decision to be made for Central. 4th and 1.
And just like we saw in the semifinals, Coach Ivester, who's an absolute legend, is going to try to go here for on a 4th down and short.
I suppose you could have pretty good arguments either way if you want to try and play field position, but, you know, 4th and 1 in flag football, and unless you're inside your own 20, you're usually going for that. So here we go. Just over 5 minutes left in the first half. And the pass complete. Allie Edwards delivered the pass. Alyssa Robeson with the catch. And a new zone gain for Central.
Runs the same play pretty much on the other side of the field. This time successfully able to pitch and catch. Again, flag football. No surprise here to see that quick catch, hot potato style offense.
Good snap, too, by Kaylee Miller that time, the senior. She's the captain of the offense up front, number 25. And one of the things she does so well for Central is she has no problem holding teammates accountable. And right on cue, they find Kaylee Miller. She's got good hands as well, Dave.
Yeah, not, maybe not the fastest person on the entire field, but good possession receiver right there. Catch the ball and get upfield, right? And have that ball extended. We'll spot the next play where the ball was when the flag was pulled. So nice job right there. You just spoke that play into existence, right? So really kudos to you for the prep work to get the ball to Kylie Miller.
And now Miller and Central starting to feel a little offensive confidence against this stingy Lithia Springs D. McEwen floats it over the middle again. And something's working there up the middle of the field. That pass caught by Chancey Powers. What do you think Central's finding?
Yeah, you know, we come into the game with a game plan. You have this offensive series, unsuccessful, trying to mix up a little bit. I like like the misdirection. I like the this receiver runs that way, and you go this way in the backfield and kind of slow down Amani Roberts up front for Lithia Springs to allow for more time for the quarterback to find the open receiver.
Lavia Shedrick with that last pull, third down, 4 yards to go to gain that next zone. McEwen hasn't had a chance to run very much, and her pass is complete. What touch on that throw. Lucy Wilkinson hauls it in, and McEwen just floated that right over the linebacker.
Yeah, Isaiah Phillips, I'm not sure you could be in a better position, but just whoop, right over her hands for the nice pitch and catch there. Again, Lucy Wilkinson, senior possession wide receiver. You've got to have those kind of players that when you're going to throw the ball to them, you know they're going to catch it. Might not break away for speed, but catch the football and the ball's thrown to him.
Boy, she's been sharp early. Central enters the express red zone. Quick pass, complete, still running. Taylor Haynes, her first touch of the afternoon. And Dave, you know, you don't want to get carried away with an offensive possession in the red zone in the first half, but this is significant. Lithia Springs hardly ever has the ball driven down the field on them like this.
Yeah, and you know, kudos to number 14 right there, Taylor Haynes, for continuing to play, right? Maybe that first flag pull should have happened. It didn't. Keep playing. Get the ball upfield. A couple extra yards there for the first down play.
One of the strengths for Central as an offense is how well they catch the ball. All sorts of different receivers early on here. And knocked loose, and a flag's going to come out. They might have caught Isaiah Phillips for trying to reach in and knock that one out. This will be our first penalty of the afternoon.
There's no flag on the play.
No flag.
So one flag down. Football rule that's new to tackle football, or different from tackle football, you can't knock the ball out of her hands. So if she has possession of the pass, you can't knock the ball out of her hands here. If you go to the replay, maybe we just rule that as an incomplete pass. She never had possession first to have the ball knocked out. So I'm okay with Cole Evan right there coming in, helping out Ben Smith on the incomplete pass.
McEwen zips it over the middle and in for the no. Her flag was pulled short. I beg your pardon. They're going to put her on the 1 yard line. I thought Kaylee Miller was in for sure.
Just spreading the ball here on the drive.
That
five receivers catching it.
Well,
her flag belt came off first. And so when her flag belt comes off inadvertently by themselves, right, accidentally, it's a one-hand touch. So much easier for the defense to stop the runner. Bad break there for the offense, the Central Lions. But again, momentum. Let's see if we can cap off this drive. Big fourth down play here as we head to the one-minute mark in the first half.
Lithia Springs has given up one touchdown in 17 games this year. Central is 1 yard away. They have been through the air almost exclusively on this drive. Well, they do it from the one, and a timeout call by the Central sideline. And look, it is not lost on them. Yes, the clock is stopped. Yes, it's the first half. But this play cannot be overstated how critical it is.
Like you said, with the stingy defense from Lithia Springs, one touchdown the entire season so far, that makes this right here, you know, you got to capitalize. Very successful drive all the way down the field. And coach knows here, hey, we got to have the right play. Just trust what got you here, right? We had a lot of receivers touching the football, so we know we have some confidence in our hands. Don't be afraid to go get a ball if you have to in the air to finish off this drive.
That one touchdown that Lithia Springs allowed this year came on November 2nd against Villarica. They were up 21-0 at that point. And if we asked Coach Pleasance about how her team reacted to giving up that score, she said they were devastated. She even had to kind of remind them, hey, we're up by 3 scores. Like,
fourth and a play.
You know, it's okay. So they take their defense very seriously. The last 10 plays for Central have been passes. And a chest pass down and in, incomplete to Kaylee Miller. And the drive stalls at the 1 yard line. to try to go to the center and Miller.
I like the play call. Again, just don't execute right there. Pass Ali Edwards a little low for the sure hand center to catch it. But again, right turnover on downs right there against now your own goal line for Lithia Springs. So not out of problem yet here for Lithia Springs.
So long as they can pick up a few yards to get out of their own end zone, they ought to be able to get to halftime with a 7-0 lead. Shedrick weaves across the line of scrimmage, dancing down the sideline, and her flag pulled right at the line to gain. Boy, she's got great burst.
Yeah, she, I mean, that's incredible how hard she runs, how fast she runs. I mean, that's faster than Rudolph on Christmas Eve. I mean, just gets it to the edge, makes one person miss, and then explodes right through the hole for a first down, extending the drive, getting out of their goal line. Exactly what Coach Pleasance wants out of the running back right there.
It's a good pull by the safety, Taylor Haynes. Minix nearly drops it. Flag ripped free. And they will say, yes, it is a sack. Minix did not get it away. Janae Adams with the stop behind the line.
Again, the pressure up front, getting to the quarterback, kind of ball coming out of her hand. Might need to try to address that at halftime for the offense there, but another hesitation play from the quarterback allows for that flag to be pulled prior to the ball being thrown.
Lithia Springs does not have to snap the ball. They can go into half with a 7-0 lead. It looks like that is exactly what they are going to do. So Lithia Springs, a touchdown on their opening drive. Central nearly scores before stalling at the 1 yard line. And I think if you're on either sideline right now, you're feeling pretty good and figure you're in for a battle. We've got John Nelson on the sidelines, and he is joined with Coach Kendra Pleasance. John.
Thank you very much, Wiley. You got the stand. You kept the zero. Seemed like Central Carroll was getting the short passing game, and they were working their way down the field. Obviously something you're going to look at here at the half.
Yes, they were making quick passes, but we're definitely going to just go and have time.
What else worked for you in the first half? Obviously the Lithia Springs that we're used to seeing with the speed at the edges and getting everything working. When you look at your first half offensively, what'd you see?
We're doing a mix of both. We're passing the ball and running the ball. I like what we're doing. We'll continue doing it and just make sure we make better decisions.
So then let me ask you this. Are you going to change anything?
Definitely.
And that is what we call a state secret. Hannah, halftime show starts right now. Coach Pleasant, unless she wants to break news, she's not going to break any news with us, but she knows that things are going to change in the second half.
Thanks, John. She's not giving anything up. All she said was definitely. Coming up on the Region's Halftime Show, we'll break down what's happened and what's to come on our GHSA Championship coverage. Check in with John and some special guests. Much more. It's all right here next on GPB.
After decades of declining rates, tobacco use is on the rise, and vaping is growing in popularity among Georgia teens. Here to tell us more about this rising trend is Kylie McElvin from Cigna. Kylie, what is vaping, and why should parents be concerned if their kids are doing it?
So vaping and the use of electronic cigarettes have been on the rise. In fact, 1 in 4 Georgia teens say they've used an electronic cigarette in the past year. And most people understand that traditional cigarettes are dangerous. A lot of teens don't understand that vapes can be just as dangerous. They still contain high levels of nicotine, just like traditional cigarettes, and can be particularly impactful on a teenage brain that's still developing.
That's so true. Why are the rates of vaping going up among teens?
So a lot of teens mistakenly believe that vapes are safer than traditional cigarettes. They also see them as more socially acceptable, so there's not as much of a stigma around them. Also, the marketing that's targeted at e-cigarettes have been very targeted at teens, so colorful packaging, flavors that are appealing to young children.
What should parents do to help their kids kick the habit?
So the number one thing they can do is understand the why. Why is their teen vaping? Is it to act out? Is it because of peer pressure from their friends? Are they using vapes or other substances to help manage anxiety or maybe another mental health condition? be sure to talk to your teen to understand why and also make sure they're educated on the dangers.
Kylie, this is so important, especially during these times. So thank you for being here. And if you want to learn more, please go to Cigna.com.
While we've got a quick break in the action, did you know that the same area of just one football field can contain up to 95 termite colonies? That's why you need Breda Pest Management to defend your home. Breda, the official pest control of high school football.
DVHDD and the Governor's Red Ribbon Campaign is about all Georgians standing together for substance abuse prevention. Celebrate life. Live drug-free. Learn more about healthy alternatives and living a drug-free lifestyle at garedribbon.org.
We continue our coverage of National Signing Day. We go now to Atlanta, Georgia for Kevin Connor's official declaration.
After giving it much thought, I've decided that next year I'll be going pro and building my skills as a Georgia plumber!
What impacted your decision?
It was an opportunity to earn money and learn on the job. I really love working with my hands, building things, and being part of a team.
Another highly touted prospect enters the trades.
Go plumber!
Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com, a proud supporter of high school athletics.
Welcome to the Football Fridays in Georgia halftime show presented by Regions. Get back in the game with Regions Bank. I'm Hannah Gooden. We're coming to you live from the GPB Sports Studios in Atlanta. It's halftime of the second GHSA Flag Football Championship game of the day. It's the Division II matchup between Lithia Springs and Central Carroll. We've got a full week of championship action. Let's take a look at what you've missed and what's to come on Georgia's EMC's scoreboard, Georgia's EMC's, so much more than electricity. So here's the game that we are in right now. The Lions held Central Carroll right before the half to lead 7-0. Then earlier today at 11 a.m., we had the D1 flag football matchup. This is 1A through 4A. Southeast Bullet took down Harris County 13-0 to go 39-0 in program history and win their second straight state championship game. Coming up next in flag football at 2:30 is the D3 matchup, which is 7A. That's Blessed Trinity versus Milton. And at 5 o'clock, it's boys single-A Division II. That will be time for some tackle football. Bowden versus Sly County, and Sly's making its first ever appearance in the finals. At 8 o'clock, it's the single-A Division I matchup, Swainsboro versus Prince Avenue Christian and PAC, back in it for 3 years in a row, winning in 2020. On Friday, it's the evens turn. At noon, it'll be Double-A Fitzgerald versus Thompson. At 3:30, it'll be the 4A matchup, Cedartown versus Benedictine. And at 7, it'll be 6A, Gainesville versus Langston Hughes. Then on Saturday, it's finally the odds turn at noon, Triple-A Sandy Creek versus Cedar Grove. Then at 3:30 in 5A, it'll be Ware County versus Warner Robins. And at 7, the grand finale will be the 7A matchup between Carrollton and Mill Creek. And believe it or not, Mill Creek is playing in its first ever state title in its 19-year history, all while doing it with freshman quarterback Juju Lewis. So that's what's happening this week on GPB, and there is much more to come here on the halftime show as well. Stick with us. We'll check in with John Nelson, who has a special guest at Center Park Stadium right after this.
The 32 participating Georgia Electric Membership Cooperatives congratulate each and every school on winning the GHSA Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. This award honors schools that exhibit exemplary sportsmanship during competitive events. Georgia's EMCs and the 32 participating membership cooperatives are proud to sponsor the Cooperative Spirit Sportsmanship Award. Congratulations to all the winners in 2022.
All right, what do you think, Jasper?
Honestly, I think that polyester shirt's faking your game.
What?
I think cotton would have been a better choice.
Cotton?
Yeah, it's come a long way, you know. Nowadays, cotton breathes and looks moisture great. Plus, buying cotton means supporting Georgia farmers. I think that's wonderful.
Okay, sure, but what do you think about the putt?
Oh, guess really hadn't thought about it.
Today's conservation-minded consumer cares about where their energy comes from. Your local EMC cares, too. Georgia's electric membership cooperatives offer renewable options for our members. In fact, our solar portfolio will produce enough clean energy to power more than 180,000 households, striving to move the needle toward progress and position communities for the future. Georgia's EMCs, so much more than electricity.
Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com. A proud supporter of high school athletics.
Respect. It's more than a word. In the U.S. Army, respect is earned every day. Now, in addition to earning respect, you may qualify for more. Information at goarmy.com/bonus or 800-USA-ARMY. Paid for by the U.S. Army.
Welcome back. It's halftime of the GHSA Division II Flag Football Championship between Lithia Springs and Central Carroll. Time now to check in with John Nelson at Center Park Stadium. And John, who do you got on the sidelines?
It is time to catch up with the principals of both of the schools. It's Kelly Edwards from Central Carroll and Travis Joshua from Lithia Springs. You guys are in the same area. You already know each other from what's going on out here. Since you're closest to me, I'm going to ask you first, Mr. Edwards. What's it like to see Central Carroll playing for a title game in a relatively new sport there on campus?
Well, I mean, it's been surreal. It's been a wonderful experience for our community, our school, our coaches. We have a new head coach this year. Our girls were just ecstatic about this whole journey. And coming here today to cap off the season has been wonderful.
And you're no stranger to this, Mr. Joshua, because this is a team that's been deep in the playoffs, chasing after championships, winning championships. What's it been like to see what Coach Pleasant and the staff have been able to do in a very short period of time?
So you said it best. That's been it. It's been our pursuit to get back on this stage here today. Last year was a triple overtime loss, and we were blessed to keep the team together, had a lot of young talent, and they made it back under the direction of Coach Pleasant for year two in the state championship game.
When it comes to the community, how has the community at Central Carroll embraced flag football? What's that been like to introduce this and have everybody come out and support it?
It's been tremendous. We had probably 200 people show up this morning to send the players off. Our school is taking a distance learning day today. Our students aren't even at school. They're here, hopefully. They're here cheering. And so it's just been great. We've had tremendous support. Community-wise, it's been great.
What about Lithia Springs?
The same. Today, we are testing, and of course, American Lit, so we weren't able to do that digital learning day, but we were able to bring out about 100 students today to support our flag football team in their quest for the state title.
Very, very cool to hear from both of you. Central Carroll and Lithia Springs, it's Mr. Edwards and Mr. Joshua. See, first name Mr., last name Edwards, Joshua. Guys, thanks for coming on and breaking everything down for Central Carroll and Lithia Springs.
Thank you so much for having us. Good luck second half.
We have a handshake, Hannah. It's amicable here in game number two. Let's send it back to you.
Yeah, John, hang out with me for just a second. In the first flag game, they were fighting over the trophy, and now shaking hands. That's awesome. We'd love to see it. John, I want to get your thoughts on the first half there. The Lions were able to hold Central Carroll right before the half, right short of getting the touchdown. What did you see from that play?
I mean, it was right there. And we talk about a game that is just a matter of inches at times. That was it. It was in and out of the hands of the receiver. The idea was there, and we were this close to getting a touchdown surrendered by Lithia Springs for the first time in a very long time. We'll catch up with Coach Ivester here coming up in just a sec and find out strategically what he thought about his short passing game that was working against that Lithia Springs defense. Is he going to work anything else into that? Because Lithia Springs was holding back the running game. It was the short passing game that was working for Central Carroll as they were trying to get that tying score, probably working with more of that come the second half.
Thanks, Sean. We'll be talking to you again very soon. So go catch up with Coach Ivester. I'm anxious to see what he has to say. And everyone, go follow us on social media at GBB Sports for constant updates throughout the championships. We are on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, TikTok this year, and Twitch.
Don't forget, you can take the games with you on the go by downloading the GPB Sports app. We're also always streaming live at gpb.org/sports and on Facebook. Shout out to our social media team, Autumn, Maya, Sandy, for absolutely killing it all the time. They're there at Center Park Stadium getting all the action for you. So go check it out there on all of our social media platforms. And fun fact, on our GPB Sports YouTube page, the flag football content is some of the most watched. So if you want to go and watch last year's championship games on YouTube, they are there. That's it for the halftime show. Thanks for watching. Let's send it back over to the booth for the second half of this game.
Thanks, Hannah. Great work back in studio. We're going to have John Nelson on the sideline speaking with Coach Ivester in a matter of moments. Central Carroll, Lithia Springs, a 7-0 ball game here at half, a state championship on the line. Central Carroll started to find some things offensively. John, what's the latest down there on the sideline with Coach Ivester?
Well, let's ask the gentleman. Obviously, one of the things that was working there late in the first half was that short passing game. They had clamped down on you in the running game. You weren't able to get to the edges, but the short passing game got you into position where you came up just short there at the end.
Yeah, we're a little familiar with them. We played them earlier in the season. We know their speed, and we felt like, you know, some of the short passes and pitch and stuff was our way to get down the field. Towards the end of the first half, we wanted to hold the ball a little bit longer and not give them a shot to get the ball back before halftime. You know, obviously we'd like to score there at the end, but we had a good play that we felt good with, and we had an option to pitch to the outside or to the center, and they did a good job on defense by pinching the middle and picking the right way we were going.
Any other adjustments you're looking at come second half?
When we get down that close to the goal line, to make sure we put it in the end zone, and hopefully we can make it a game and have a shot at the end. That's all we're asking for.
Thanks for your time.
All right, appreciate it.
That's the lowdown here on the Central Carroll sideline. Miley, let's send it back to you upstairs and get ready for the second half.
Ellie, second half moments away. Let's take a look back at the first 20 minutes and what we saw. Opening drive for Lithia Springs. They're moving the ball down the field. They played 3 overtimes in the state championship game last year. Didn't score a point. It took them just their first drive of the afternoon to get in the end zone. There's Brill Holland with a nice catch. And then here, the touchdown from Nevaeh Shedrick, a 1-yard scamper into the end zone. So 7-0 Lithia Springs. Central with the response against this stingy Lithia Springs defense and soft tossing from Camry McEwen. They got down to the 1-yard line, 4th and goal from the 1, and at the shoelaces of Kaylee Miller. Central comes up empty. Here's a look at the halftime stats, and boy, Dave, I look at those rushing yards for Central, and I'm pretty shocked because Camry McEwen, such a big part of their season this year, has been her ability to run the ball. Instead, they've asked her to go to the air.
Yeah, the nice matchup up front for Lithia Springs with the rusher, Monty Roberts, but a slow down, a shifted quarterback. And, you know, very underwhelming offensive stats there on the ground for what they're used to be able to run the football and have their way. So far in the first half, not that way for Central Carroll.
And as Coach Ivester mentioned, Lithia Springs and Central Carroll faced off about a month ago in area play, both out of Area 6. Lithia Springs picked up a 19-0 win. And Lithia Springs had their hearts broken last year. In triple overtime, they lost to Dodge County. Coach Kendra Pleasance said that postgame meeting was really tough. They were talking about, you know, what they could have done differently. They were such a young group. They felt confident that they had a chance to do something special this year, returning nearly everyone. And now a couple of seniors in Isaiah Phillips and Naya Moore, number 10 and number 8, and White, along with the strong junior class of Shedrick and Minix. They're in position. And as we mentioned, they gave up one touchdown the whole season. If you told them up 7-0, 20 minutes to kill, I think they'd take that.
Right. And, you know, if you're recapping the first half, don't forget about that third down play that the flag bell fell off the center. She's trying to get into the end zone. Sometimes we see the flag belt fall off, sometimes more than others here and there, but the flag belt is adjustable. So it's all about that clamp right there in the front. And unfortunately for Central Carroll's offense there, the flag belt falls off. It becomes a one-hand touch situation after that. It makes it easier for the defense there, especially right there at the half-inch yard line to stall that drive there. but got the ball back here to start the second half. Let's see what we can do.
So first and six from the 14-yard line. It's an 80-yard field here in flag football. Cameron McEwen, a little miscommunication between her and Alyssa Robeson. Robeson broke up the sideline. McEwen was expecting her to stay put.
Imani Roberts, again, continuing to apply the pressure. Eyes downfield, just dumps the ball, gets rid of it. Live to play another day. Don't force anything. Nice job, Imani Roberts. Sack leader from the Lithia Springs Lions. Nice job applying pressure so far all day today.
And while you look at the clock and say, okay, 19 and a half minutes, plenty of time. Now that first half, each team had the ball just three times. That was it, Ted. Pass falls incomplete, looking for Allie Edwards. Now third down and six.
Yeah, only three possessions, especially with the Central Carroll offense. Coach likes to have the quarterback, as you can see, come to the sideline. The two of them process what's going on defensively, make adjustments, get a play call in there. So maybe not the most common approach offensively to have the quarterback go to the sideline, but one we definitely see here for Central Carroll.
Got to get to the 20 or the 30 on the field if you read the numbers. And that pass complete. Beautiful touch. Camry McEwen finds Chancey Powers.
And watch where she catches the football. Just catch the ball. And those first two steps are very explosive. A nice job in Lithia Springs defense to have three people around them to shut that down. But fastest receiver right there. Go-to receiver, Chancey Powers, picks up a big first down.
Camry McEwen, Central's quarterback, said she threw the ball about three or four times last year. It is a totally different ball game for her this season. She completes another pass to Allie Edwards, a modest gain. Pull made by Isaiah Phillips.
Kind of see the blocker right there. Allie Edwards, she lines up there to block, but then slips off for a nice safety foul for the quarterback to keep the drive going. Again, the misdirection there for Central Carroll's offense, I think it's helping slow down a little bit the pursuit by Lithia Springs.
So a gain of four, now second and eight. Midfield for the next zone to gain. McEwen under pressure, completes it. No, incomplete. Looking for Chancey Powers. Thought she might have gotten one of those feet in. Third down.
Very impressive here as she rolls the pocket and then she running, I don't know, and then just quick release. Woo! Gets the ball out. Oh! Gets the toe out of bounds. Good call there by the line judge, Ben Smith. Getting that incomplete pass.
Third down and eight. Powers reverse. Deep shot. Nobody there. Trying a little creativity. That was Alyssa Robeson. And the pass was thrown by Taylor Hayes. So fourth down and eight. I think it'd be wise to play field position here, right?
You know, again, coach, absolutely a legend right there, but I think you have to early in the first half. Kick the ball, play field position. Your defense is what got you here. Rely on that to get the ball back.
Deep drop for Robeson. Spiraling punt. Caught cleanly by My Angel Ross. Good pursuit. And the flag yanked away. 24-yard punt, no yards on the return. It was Lana Adams with a stop, I believe.
First drive here for Lithia Springs. See if we can get the quarterback to calm it down a little bit again. A lot of bobbles in the first half, indecision in the first half. Let's see if we can get the junior quarterback a little more comfortable in throwing this football.
Shia Minix, her second year as a starter. And it's Shedrick trying to stretch it out around the sideline. Nothing there. And a good pull. Lucy Wilkinson as Shedrick tried to split the defense.
Again, not much there. You can see the footwork just chopping, chop, 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 chop. for Shedrick right there looking for a hole, but the defense there for Sunder Carroll just pursues to the football. Minimal gain for number nine.
Shedrick always wanted to play tackle football, and she has relished her time as a flag player. Only a junior, still got one more year. Pass in and out of the hands. Nigel Ross heard the footsteps of Wilkinson. Can't make the catch, and now third and Wheelor.
This kind of pass is what shows Rashad Minix is growth as a passer. The arm strength there, nice tight spiral. Hits the wide receiver right where she's supposed to. I'm pretty sure Nigel Ross won that ball back.
Got to get to midfield for a new set of downs. Minix, nearly 6 yards deep, takes the snap. And the flag comes off. It's a sack for Janae Adams in Central. Opts to play field position, and they've created a fourth and long. Fourth and 21, and a punt coming for Lithia Springs.
Just fantastic pressure up front by the senior rusher. That's exactly what the doctor ordered for the Central Carroll defense.
And for the first time today, Lithia Springs will punt. Bethany King, a soccer player that Coach Pleasance discovered in PE class, to be their punter a couple years ago. She can boom it. Low line drive kick. And because it's not fielded cleanly, it's a dead ball. It sits down right at the 35-yard line. So all in all, pretty good spot for Central. We got first and five after the 26-yard punt.
You know, Coach is probably telling the quarterback right here, hey, let's keep doing what got us here. We had success in the last drive of the first half. Not afraid here maybe to take a shot here, first and five, maybe take a shot offensively, but you know, get back to that bread and butter here of pitch and catch, spreading the football around to multiple wide receivers.
Four wide right, single up back. McHugh is going to try and run left. And not much there, maybe a yard. Trying to find a way to get her legs involved, Dave, but you know, for as great as McEwen's speed is, Lithia Springs has plenty of that, especially laterally on the defensive side.
Yeah, Coach Pleasant's just, with Amani Roberts up front, you can just trust her with uncounted money, just applying that pressure play after play to slow down the impact play here for Central Carroll.
So second and four. Throws it over the middle. Oh, dangerous pass. Anna McIver was there. She's has 12 interceptions on the season. Nearly had number 13.
A little misdirection up front again. Able to slow down the pressure. Maybe trying to force something there across the middle and a lot of traffic. But third and manageable here. This is probably four down territory for the offense.
McEwen 9 for 16, 79 yards. Central prides themselves with the number of possession receivers they have. McEwen caught and about a yard, maybe a yard and a half short. Catch was made by Allie Edwards.
Yet we've seen this play before. Quarter, a running back runs across the formation, picks up a couple yards, exactly what you want. Coach knows that that was the third down, was a fourth down territory kind of play. Cut it in half, makes it so much more manageable here. Let's see if we can execute on a short pass, probably in the middle somewhere.
There is a short pass. Oh, it's broken up. A flag comes flying in from the head referee. McEwen was trying to connect with Taylor Haynes. Let's see what the call is here from Nick O'Donnell. It's going to be against Lithia Springs.
Yeah, very aggressive, very physical play there. Just runs right to the opponent. I like the call by Nick O'Donnell, Georgia Tech alumni. Converts for a first down, so the drive still stands. tough break there for this Lithia Springs defense.
So first down and 11 now after the penalty of 10 yards. Midway point of the second half. Central driving. And that pass well too short.
That's a super tough pass. You're rolling to your right, and you want to try to throw it back across the formation. I highly doubt that was her first read. Again, rolling to her right, throwing back across her body. Tough pass. Not surprised it fell short.
Lithia Springs scored on the opening drive of the game. Central drove it all the way down to the one late in the first half. Couldn't score. This is their second possession of the second half. McEwen taking a shot deep, and she overthrows her target, Melissa Robeson. Now third down and 11. And again, you would think this is two down territory. You're in plus territory.
Yeah, coach knows right here we're going for it on fourth down. Let's try to chop this third and 11 to half of that instead of a more manageable fourth down. Haven't seen a whole lot of deep balls for Central's offense. That's maybe the second or third one of the day. I'd expect a little more shorter here again. We need to chop this in half to make it a fourth down more manageable.
Two on the play clock. They got to get it off. They just barely do. McEwen out and running, and what a pull! Imani Roberts, man. Fully extended and sprawling as she snared the back flag of McEwen.
I mean, speed on speed. That's all that is. Athlete on athlete. Somebody has to win. Nice job laying out for that flag pull. You know, the nice thing about the Lithia Springs defense, and even if that first flag pull is missed, you've got another senior linebacker right there to help shut that play down.
So here we go, fourth and eight. Just over 8 minutes left in the second half. Central trying to tie it up. Rolling right, nowhere to go. Imani Roberts, the MVP of that defensive stand for Lithia Springs. Lithia Springs, a 7-0 lead, less than 8 minutes to play. We'll crown a state champion when we come back.
Commute with confidence. Express can take you to and from work. Just sit back, relax, and enjoy the ride. More information at expressga.com, a proud supporter of high school athletics.
At Regions Bank, we're here to listen to your needs, and we'll customize a plan to help you reach your financial goals. Our service to Georgia goes beyond banking to creating more inclusive prosperity in our communities. From education to financial wellness to economic development, we're working to level the playing field so more people can succeed and our communities can thrive.
Respect. It's more than a word. In the U.S. Army, respect is earned every day. Now, in addition to earning respect, you may qualify for more. Information at goarmy.com/bonus or 800-USA-ARMY. Paid for by the U.S. Army.
A beautiful afternoon in downtown Atlanta Center Park Stadium. Our second of three flag football state championships. Pitt Central, Carroll against Lithia Springs, Lions against Lions. And Lithia Springs, who has allowed just one touchdown all season long, a 7-0 lead, and the football. Wiley Ballard joined by David Reynolds, John Nelson on the sidelines. Nevaeh Shedrick weaving around the right side. She's got the edge, and the flag seized by Macy Williams. And one storyline here, our statistician Kevin Barnes just passed this to me, Dave. Cameron McEwen in the first half went 8-for-11 for 55 yards. In the second half, she is 2-for-9 for 27 yards. Lithia Springs made an adjustment on those short passes. Of a play fake there from Brio Holland. And she has first her shorts, then her flag. Brings a third and short close to midfield.
Really nice contain right here for Janae Adams to force that back up into the middle. Chancey Powers, or force that back up to the middle to allow her teammates to be able to pull the flag. Big play right here.
Just 1 yard to gain that new zone. Where else did they go but Shedrick? A flag is thrown. Where's the spot on the play? I think I'm lose a yard there. We'll see the flag as well. Illegal motion. So now a little bit of a decision though, right? You could just take the result of the play and it'd be 4th and 2.
Illegal motion on the offense. That penalty's declined. 4th down.
I think that's the right call to decline that penalty.
Yeah, but if you're Coach Pleasant, it don't change a thing for you. You know what you're doing. You're going to feed the rock to number 9 here. You're going to ride what got you here.
No, they're going to punt.
Oh, what do I know? Unbelievable.
I suppose that when you have a defense that's given up 1 touchdown all year, well, you could argue one way or the other, I guess.
I like it.
All right, so Bethany King is on the booming away. Again, punts can be returned in flag football so long as they are fielded cleanly. Oh, wow. What a punt down to the 2-yard line, a 40-yard boot from Bethany King. And that's a long way to go against this Lithia Springs offense.
Soccer player out of PE class, are you kidding me? Just the whole team says get away from it. That ball bounce is kind of funny sometimes. Checks up right there. 2-yard line, that dog will hunt. So now you got a massive football field ahead of you for the offense, but kudos number 65, right? Not a very common flag football number for pinning their team back deep in their own territory.
Well, shout out to Bethany King, the punter, getting some camera time. That's hard to do. So from the 2-yard line, Kaylee Miller laterals it back. It's caught by Edwards, and Nevaeh Shedrick says not so fast.
A lot of pitch and catch right there. I like getting the center involved again. But just nothing right there. Just that fast flying around defense, shutting that play down pretty quickly.
Well, with the way Coach Ivester likes to send his plays in with his quarterback, it makes it a little tougher to play with some pace. As time is a factor, and the idea of giving the ball back to Lithia Springs and still getting it back afterwards with some time left could be really challenging. 2nd and 17. Oh, nearly intercepted by Brielle Holland. 3rd and 17.
Coach knows what he has to do here. A little surprised that we're still going to the short route. Again, maybe that's kudos to the Lithia Springs defense flying around, but at some point you got to risk it to get the biscuit. So we need to start opening the playbook up a little bit here, even on 3rd down for Central Carroll.
Are you taking a shot here, or are you trying to get half of it knowing you're going to go on 4th, or do you not even go on 4th if you get there? You're so deep in your own territory.
Yeah, you know, if Lithia Springs has a decent drive, you're not getting the ball back. Take the defense gives you here.
Deep shot. It is incomplete. Robeson in double coverage. Well done by Hannah McIver and Anaya Moore, who were teaming up to shut that down.
4th and a kick.
Yeah, here's a shot deep. Just double coverage. Nice job staying at home. Safety's not had a whole lot of action today, but a good job getting over top to knock that ball down.
Clock is ticking, so Central be best advised to punt as quickly as possible. Pretty good punt. Handled by Holland up the right sideline. Her flag yanked away by Cameron McEwen. 2:43. Now Central has 2 timeouts as well as the 1 minute warning. So they can get the ball back, but if they get the first down here, that is likely your ball game.
Yeah, and again, if you're Coach Pleasant from Lithia Springs, stay with what got you here. Feed that rock to number 9. Let her make those important decisions.
Shedrick around the right side. Great play in the backfield. Lucy Wilkinson. And right now, you know, Lithia Springs is thinking to themselves, they were so close a year ago, lost the state championship in triple overtime. can almost taste a perfect season on the heels of that loss. And Lithia Springs calls a timeout.
Yeah, a little surprising right there, Coach Pleasant. I'm sure she had a game plan, but you know, if you're going to call a timeout, maybe milk that clock a little bit. But as you look in the huddle, right, Coach Pleasant, she knows what's on the line right here. I mean, she is as cool as the other side of the pillow when you talk to her, when you watch her coach on the sideline. Never too high, never too low, just complete competitor, in control of her roster. So maybe want to make sure we get the right play call here on second down.
Coach Ivester, meanwhile, on the other side, trying to find a stop. Second down at 6. I think you could potentially give up a first down on this play and still get the ball back with little time left. But Minix over the middle. It's caught and running free towards the end zone. Touchdown, Jaden Graham, Lithia Springs. A 2-score lead, less than 2 minutes to go. And the green and gold can sense the championship coming. Jaden Graham, the sophomore who missed the postseason last year due to injury. She is the hero this afternoon.
Great googly moogly. I mean, just the dagger. Plenty of people to pull flags there. Nice job, Jaden Graham, for keeping the feet moving and get that ball across the goal line.
And the point after complete to my Angel Ross. 14-0. We're going to hit the 1 minute warning. It was aggressive to call that timeout by Coach Pleasance, but boy, did she drop the right play.
What a great opportunity to get her first receiving touchdown of the season. Again, just people all around her. Nice job to Will and finding a way to get the ball across the goal line there for her team. Big moment, big play, big stage. Nice job, Jaden Graham.
Just a sophomore, that is her first receiving touchdown of the season. Boy, she picked a good time, huh? Might have been the state championship clincher. Here comes Mickey Ewan trying to run. And she's still up and around, and the flag is pulled. Oh, no, a collision between a couple of Lithia Springs defenders, Imani Roberts and Isaiah Phillips. Oh, my, I hope they're okay. Coach Pleasance racing out to the field to check on her players. Looks like Phillips is okay. Roberts as well. Here's the collision. Ooh!
So one thing you might be asking yourself, why are these athletes wearing mouthpieces out here and they don't have helmets? Well, again, kudos to the rule book for having mouthpieces as a required piece of equipment for an unusual situation where friendly fire right there, head-to-head collision.
So Isaiah Phillips will catch a breather. Assistant coaches Darius Owens and Trey Hightower checking in on her. First down for Central. Incomplete. Clock will stop with 43 seconds left. And McEwen now 2 for 12 through the air in the second half after she was 8 for 11 in the first half.
Isaiah Phillips checks back in for the defense. New rusher up front with the Imani Roberts out. Olivia Fortner up there. See if we can continue to apply the pressure, continue to have that success that the Lithia Springs off defense has had so far today.
McEwen incomplete, looking for Robeson. Third and 14. Quite a run for Central this year. A team that lost 5 regular season games, and in their 4 playoff wins, each of them came on the final possession. They'd kind of had that magic, that rabbit's foot, whatever you want to call it. Looks like it'll run out today, though, as Lithia Springs 38 seconds away from yet another shutout. McEwen has her flag yanked from Isaiah Phillips. And timeout called by Central. this might be an opportunity just for Coach Ivester to savor these final 30 seconds in what has been an extremely special season for Central Carroll. And for Lithia Springs, it's been, I don't think satisfying does it justice for a team that reached the state finals last year, lost in triple overtime, has given up just one touchdown this year. They are 30 seconds away from being 18-0 and our second undefeated flag football state champion this year. And it will be our last. We've got Milton and Blessed Trinity in the Division III game slated to begin around 2:30. Both those teams already had a couple of losses. So fourth down and seven.
Hey, make a play.
Coach Ivester trying to get his team to focus and just picking up another first down here, finishing strong. McEwen guns it in, it's broken up. Looking for Taylor Haynes. And with that, Central does have one timeout left. Not sure if they'd want to use it or not, but potentially just one kneel down and Lithia Springs will have come all the way back from losing in triple overtime a year ago. And the hugs on the Lithia Springs Lions sideline are happening. Minix takes a knee. And that is going to do it. Lithia Springs, state champions, all the way back. And this time they finish the job. They have left no doubt. Pleasants told us that they had a perfect record, but they were far from a perfect team. But when they look back at this season, they're going to see 18-0 state championship and one touchdown allowed the whole season.
You hate to be cliche, but you understand that defense wins championship. That's exactly what you saw on display here for Lithia Springs. Both teams, passion, energy, effort, desire to win. Lithia Springs comes out on top today. Shout out to both teams, by the way, and bringing their bands with them. Something that, as we continue for this sport to grow, something very exciting for both programs. But, man, awesome to see Coach Pleasants have a little smile, show a little extra emotion there in her victory moment. So, congratulations, Lithia Springs.
That's a pretty serious heartbreak a year ago, losing a triple overtime, but it is all joy for the green and gold as Lithia Springs will head to the center of the field to receive their state championship trophy. We'll send it down to John Nelson momentarily. But Lithia Springs, undefeated state champions in 2022. A really fun group to watch throughout the season. First, Coach Ivester gets his runners-up trophy. Not bad for a guy coaching his first high school sport as a head coach this year. So Central Carroll finishes the year 14-6. Runners-up in the state, runners-up in the area to Lithia Springs. Now we'll go down to the field to John Nelson.
Thank you very much, Wiley Ballard. It is that time. First and foremost, shout out to our friends at Central Carroll. Tremendous season in flag football. Well done out there in Carroll County. Central Carroll, fantastic season for the Lions. But it is that time where we present the trophy to the champs again. To do that, it's the executive director of the Georgia High School Association, Dr. Robin Hines.
First, I want to congratulate Central on a great season and want to congratulate that community for showing up in force to support your team. Thank you so much. But now it gives me great pleasure to present you with this championship trophy to Lithia Springs. Congratulations on a dominating season. How are you feeling right now?
It's a great feeling. The girls, they worked so hard all season long, and I'm proud of them.
Coach, grab that trophy. Hardest question you will have all weekend. How does that feel?
It feels good. Let's get ready for Disney, ladies.
Have you had a chance to even think about how stout your defense was, only giving up the one touchdown all season long? Have you had a chance to sit there and go, this was a really special team, completing really special things?
We stay disciplined. That's just been our motto all year long, taking it one game at a time and playing good defense.
Where does this trophy go?
First, it's going to go in my office. And next, we're going to put it in a trophy case.
Where it belongs. Lithia Springs, champs, once again, the Lions in 4-5. Wiley Ballard, take it away.
Thank you, John. Lithia Springs, undefeated, 18-0. They come all the way back after losing to the state final last year. They win it this year. Douglas County Zone, the green and gold takedown. Central Carroll, the second flag football state champion to be crowned today. Lithia Springs High School, congratulations to the Lions. For David Reynolds, I'm Wiley Ballard saying so long. Good afternoon, and don't go anywhere because we have Hannah Gooden on the other side of this break before we get set for the third and final flag football state championship. Your final score, Lithia Springs 14, Central Carroll, nothing.
Hi, I'm Tommy Sharp with You Save It Pharmacy, and I'm proud to present to you this week's You Save It Pharmacy Student Athlete of the Week.
When you look at a kid that just unbelievable character and where he's come from and what he's done with his life, and it's just an unbelievable story.
I want to be known as a person they could talk to, like they could reach out and if you need help, I'll be there.
Caesar has a tremendous mom and dad.
I want to be like them, and I want to make it out of a tough time working hard.
I hope you've enjoyed watching You Save It's Pharmacy Student Athlete of the Week. If you'd like to watch our full interview, please follow this link.
Hey everyone, welcome into the GPB Tailgate Party. I'm Hannah Gooden. We're live from the GPB Sports Studios in Atlanta. The GHSA Division II Flag Football Championship is in the books, and we've crowned another winner. We've got a jam-packed week of championship games. Let's take a look back at the first flag football title game and what's to come on Georgia's EMC scoreboard. Georgia's EMC's so much more than electricity. So we just wrapped up Lithia Springs versus Central Carroll, and the Lions took down Central Carroll 14-0. They scored again in the final 2 minutes to put it away to go 18-0 on the season. They're back in the championship game for the second year in a row in their 2 years as a program, earning their first title and avenging last year's triple overtime loss to Dodge. So congratulations, ladies. This morning at 11 a.m., it was our first title. This was Division I, which is single A through 4A. Southeast Bullock beat Harris County 13-0 to go 39-0 in program history and earn its second straight state championship in 2 years. It was their seventh shutout in a row and 14th overall. So congratulations to head coach Marcy Cochran and the Yellow Jackets. Coming up next, we've got Blessed Trinity and Milton at 2:30. It's the D3 matchup in flag football, which is 7A. We're going to hear from Eagles head coach Clark Nixon later in the show. Then we are going to start tackle football at 5 o'clock. Boys single A Division II matchup between Bowdoin and Sly County. It's Sly's first ever appearance in the finals. And at 8 o'clock tonight, it's Single-A Division One between Swainsboro and Prince Avenue Christian. PAT back in it for 3 years in a row, trying to win their first one since 2020. Then on Friday, it's the evens. At 12 o'clock, we'll have the AA matchup between Fitzgerald and Thompson. Fitzgerald's in the finals for the third year in a row and the defending champs. At 3:30, it's the 4A matchup between Cedartown and Benedictine. Benedictine is the defending 4A champs as well. And at 7 o'clock, it's the 6A game, Gainesville versus Langston Hughes. And Hughes trying to avenge that tough loss to Buford in the finals a year ago. On Saturday, it's the odds turn at noon. It will be AAA Sandy Creek versus Cedar Grove. And Cedar Grove has won 4 state titles in 7 years. They were also the 3A state champs in 2021. At 3:30, it'll be the 5A matchup between Ware County and Warner Robins. And at 7 o'clock, we'll round out the with it with 7A, Carrollton versus Mill Creek. Time now to check in with my buddy John Nelson, who has the Cotton Commission Player of the Game from the Division II final matchup. John, tell her I said congratulations.
Hannah Gooden says congratulations, Nevaeh, by the way.
Oh, tell her I said thank you.
Nevaeh Shedrick, junior running back, linebacker, Lion extraordinaire for Lithia Springs. She's our Georgia Cotton Commission Player of the Game, the Georgia Cotton Commission, the natural choice for Georgia. What's it like to be champs once again?
It feels so amazing. I can't do nothing but just be in awe, you know, thank God. Of course, thank all the training that I had with track and flag, and thank my teammates because we all work together. It wouldn't be possible without them.
Let's talk about the defense, because this defense is one of the stingiest defenses I've seen in quite some time, whether we're talking tackle football or flag football. Only the one touchdown that you guys gave up all season long, and it seemed even with that you took it personal. What was this defense like this year?
This year, it was everything was personal, everything. We was taking it one game at a time, like my coach said, starting from Imani Roberts, the rusher, all the way down to Zaya, Hannah, Anaya, my angel, all of them, Brielle, Yana, all of them. Like, we locking down, like, no matter what. Like, we just got to take care of business.
And excellent work there naming every player on defense. That was good stuff. Okay, so now let's name every player on offense. You guys have scored in the 20s. You guys have won the tight ones. What's it been like there as one of the two-way players for a coach this year?
It's been an amazing experience. Rashaya, Kasaja, our quarterbacks. You got Jaden, you got Hannah, Anaya, Azaya, and my angel. And you got even the girls who are coming in behind. Like, it's been such a great experience from the blocks. Everybody plays a very special role. Like, I just love them so much.
Last question for you. What's it been like to see flag football grow there at Lithia Springs to where it is and to see the support that you guys out there today? What's it been like to see this grow to where it is now?
Oh, my God, it's been amazing. Last year, we didn't have as much support. Nobody really, like, knew about us. We were, like, a new team coming out. But just looking in the stands today and, like, hearing people around, like, oh, I'm going to a flag football game, it felt amazing to see it grow today.
Nevaeh Shedrick, our Georgia Cotton Commission Player of the Game, for the win over Central Carroll. Congratulations. Go celebrate with your team. And adapt to go. You got to like how that goes.